Tigers in the house. State champs in the house.
Textbook, baby, let's go.
Hey, keep it in. Take yourself, Kaz.
Let's go. Hey, way to get it.
Come on, guys. Come on.
Come on, Padre! Come on, Padre! Come on, Pete!
Because you're, you know why? Because you're a pussy. All right.
Good.
I'm glad you're
pussy.
Blame it on something.
anyway, let's talk about why you got a victory today.
I got a victory because
of your boy wants
ball on defense.
Your
let me
boy
tell you,
once
the best
again.
Team in the state, you out.
We are not the best defensive team in the state, by the way. But today, we did play well. And these two guys, I thought the big play in the game was him catching that ball.
Yeah.
And I think it was the first inning.
No, second.
Second.
Come on, man.
Big double
your whole
play.
Life is this. How do you not know?
Big double play
inning?
Turned by Cassella. Right? Big double play, unassisted double play.
Yeah.
But obviously the big blow of the game is, you know, we're not a team that hits home runs. They intentionally
they
walk
their life to Colombia.
First of all, they intentionally walk Coochie to get to you. So obviously they don't have the scouting report.
No, sir.
You come through bigger bat, you come through with the sack fly and we tie the game. Talk about that.
Well, you know, when Coochie put the bat down, kind of put a little fire under my ass that they didn't know who was coming to the plate, so had to do a job there.
Yeah, the outfield's playing in on Cassella.
And you got the job done, here's what I'm thinking, and again,
no, I was lost in that.
Think about, listen, I'm a coach in that spot, you're 3-0 in a count, and then they get a sack fly, so it's almost a victory for them, right? Because they're thinking 3-0.
Yeah.
So that's why your at-bat was so huge. They'd be thrilled to get out of that 4-4.
Yeah, no. I mean, if you ask Joe or anyone, you know, the last couple of days have kind of been swinging like dog shit, even the BP rounds and stuff. And I've been working with Coach Farcio, getting my foot down. And so, you know, I went up there and I was like, all I needed to do was really just get my foot down. I was kind of stalling in the air, and then all of a sudden everything would just go quick. So in my head, I said, just get your foot down, get your foot down. It was a fastball up, and I just swung, and I hit it pretty hard. So.
Now were you thinking of home run there?
No, with two outs.
Nobody
with two wants. Outs, two outs.
Talking to him, jackass. Shut your mouth.
Two outs, man on second. You know, I was just trying to hit a ball hard because, like I said, you know, my first time I got on, I bunted. You know, there wasn't a lot of confidence going into that bat, to be completely honest. But I said, you know what, screw it. You know, you got to be a guy here. A lot of kids look up to you. You got to get it done, so.
Energy was there. Like you said, you got the bunt. You made a great play defensively. You also throw a guy out at the plate.
I thought he scored. That's why I didn't even back up.
But I botched it. I botched it. And you know what? Thank God on this.
Yeah.
It,
he stopped it, when
you know, he
thank
stopped.
God was watching?
Then, yeah.
You think,
oh, yeah. I know you don't believe him. But the ball bounced perfectly after it went, and it was, like, perfect.
Yeah, we don't need, like, a play-by-play detail of it. But the point is, you had a huge game. You throw a guy out. You make a great catch. You get a bunt. Single, and then you hit the 3-run home run, and then Cassella big, and also another big hit, and then get back to you. I thought
you got bitch slapped in the third inning. Let's talk about the third inning.
I blame the rain. They're a good hitting team, but I blame the rain.
How'd you pack my stuff?
Ask Cassella, right, Cass?
Oh yeah.
The rain.
One inning, it rained.
So repeat after me. I am a.
I knew he was going to say it.
You're not putting that in there, so I know you're not.
Talk about the outing.
Defense had my back big time. That play that Pete made, spectacular. Cassella was on lock. Even Spalter, that one play that got hit up the middle, even though he didn't get him out. I mean, that's still a great play by Spall, keeping in the infield.
Team goes down. You go down. You're up 3-0, then you're down 4-3. What's going through your head?
I'm fine. I'm good. I know he was fine too. He hit that bomb. He was fine. just gotta relax.
Mentally being strong and getting a lead, but also playing with energy and pressure.
Stop stealing my character. Shut up.
I'm just saying, bro. We all come together when we're not selfish.
Do we know who we got next round? South Bronx album? We don't know yet.
Yeah, anyway, we're coming.
Congratulations.
Yeah, Fish has got him.
Congratulations.
Hold on, where's Fish though?
We're coming.
Let's Fish though!
Oh, look who's in the house.
You're all wet. All right, Coach, you got to the semifinals.
That's it.
You are now 14-0 in sections over the last 4 years.
So far.
And this one was anything but a very weird game. We get a 3-0 lead, which is rare for us, right? We're the type of team that kind of scuffles. We get the 3-0 lead, and you got Joey on the hill. You're probably thinking you're in good shape. And in the blink of an eye, you're down 4-3. So talk to me about what's going on in your mind at that point.
Honestly, I'm just thinking kind of like the term we've used over the last couple of weeks is kind of snake bitten. And you know, we give up that lead, rain's pouring down, and then it stops. Stops for them, but it's pouring during our inning. It's when they get all their runs, and
you're not blaming the rain like
no,
Joey D is, right?
Not.
Because
no,
Joey
no.
D is making excuses that the rain is the reason why he had a bad inning.
No.
You're not doing that,
no,
right?
We're not doing that. I'm just saying.
All right.
No, with a one-run lead, they had, you know, confident that our guys were going to come back. They have had good at-bats early in the game. Figured that, you know, their intensity was there. Their approach was there today. Joey was throwing well on the mound. We would come back. I had a good feeling about that. And then it was just coming down to playing the game well all the way through. And they did. It was one of their better played games all season in terms of, you know, pitching, hitting, defense all the way through. And it's really what, you know, allowed guys to come up with, you know, big hits today. And it's one of the things that we've been missing, you know, as of late. And today it all came at the right time.
Not only big hits, but you set a fielder. I mean, he really owned the game.
Yeah.
I mean, you think about the play. He cuts down the runner at the plate. That was huge. I mean, think about it. That's another run, and that inning's still going. He makes that tremendous catch in center field. And then, of course, he gets the bunt single, the energy he gives you, and then the home run. I mean, it was his day today.
Yeah, and it just comes down to the heart he has, you know, through the course of the season, his ups and downs, and just you know, being able to get through all that and come out when you need him the most, he had a huge game. You know, defensively, offensively, it was just his time today, and he capitalized. He was clutch today.
I thought Cassella had a good game defensively, that big double play turn, and, of course, big spot in the game. They walk Cucci to get to Cassella.
Yeah.
And that allows Pete to get in a bat in that
sure.
inning.
Yeah, listen, Cass has been, you know, arguably one of the better players, I would say, in the entire state this year. So what
yeah,
he's done,
he's been
you
so
know,
good.
He's been
clearly, you're our best hitter. You know, he's
human, but it seems like every game he has at least one, mostly two good at bats.
He's been our glue. He's been our glue. So anytime he comes to play in a big situation, you know that, you know, something can happen. So
cool. Who do we got next? Do we know?
Hey, see the South Brunswick room now, but I got to get on the phone and find out.
All right, good luck, coach.
All right, thank you.
So Joey D was using the rain as an excuse. Have you ever used the rain as an excuse in your lifetime?
No.
How about you?
One at mom.
You don't do that shit, right?
Hey, guys.
How about you?
Oh, no.
Big dog.
Is that what Joey did today?
No, no, I'm just asking.
Remember last year I said the rain?
I don't think I ever have.
You ever have? Okay, just check. You've never used it in your life.
I don't think so.